all, I'm Jennifer Zilliotto. Today I decided to spend the afternoon preparing my cashmere and wool sweaters for the summer to prevent moths getting to them. Really easy to do, and I thought I'd show you how I do it. So basically I take all my sweaters out of the drawer and start to get them ready. I like to have a couple of basins going at once so that I can make the process a little bit faster. So I'll take my sweater and I'll just dunk it into cold water. And the thing about cashmere, I'm starting with my cashmere first, it really doesn't like being agitated too much. I've done videos on this before. We just want to let it soak. For the detergent, I'm using the Unscented Company, their dish liquid. It's nice and mild and it's unscented, but I could use a fabulous Savon de Marseille, or if you don't have either of these kind of products, just a gentle, mild detergent. Something like even shampoo is great. And now I'm just gonna let these two sweaters that I have going here soak for a little bit. So I have rinsed my, this is actually a cashmere dress, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna lightly press it to get the excess water out. I don't wanna wring it. Now, with my woolen sweaters or some of the synthetic blends, I tend to do a load in the washing machine under the delicate cycle. If you have that in your washing machine, that's really great for your woolens. But things like cashmere and 100% wool, merino wool, for instance, I rather wash by hand because of shrinkage. It's so disappointing when we haven't properly taken care of our clothes. So I now have two pieces here drying, and realistically this task is going to take me over the course of a few days to complete. So I have a beautiful cashmere dress from the other day that is nice and dry, and I'm going to get it ready to store. So what I like to do lastly is take an essential oil that is a scent that I know moths don't like. For instance, cedarwood, a classic. Or if you don't have cedarwood, or if you don't really like the smell, then you can use lavender. They don't like that also. Or if you don't have an essential oil, then you can consider using a soap that has a lavender scent into it and keep that tucked in to the spot where you store all your pieces. That's a great thing to do too. Anything to deter these pesky moths that eat our beautiful clothes and ruin. So now I take the essential oil and I just lightly sort of pat it into the fibers of the dress because it smells so good and it's an extra added deterrent. I take my, and if you wanted, you could add a few drops to your washing liquid, that's nice too. So I take my dress and/or sweater, whatever it is, and I tuck it away in a Ziploc bag. And at the end of the summer, when I'm ready to get my pieces out again, I just reuse the same Ziplocs, keep these stored in a bag so it's easy to go come the spring. Now, if you have a really persistent moth problem, you may want to consider putting your cashmere or your woolens in the freezer for a few nights. This will absolutely kill any of the eggs that are still left on the fibers. They're really hard to get rid of, and the freezing temperature completely kills those eggs. Now this is ready to get stored. Really, really easy. So there you go, really, really simple to take care of your cashmere and your woolen sweaters, get them ready for storage for the summer. Hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already, and of course, for more style ideas, for more inspiration, you can follow me on Facebook and on Instagram.